It's JBo and Yoshi on Boost 101.9, talking to my best friend, Tori Kelly.
So we're going to start off with a little game, kind of, you know, to...
Icebreaker,
yeah. This game's called Word Blurt.
Okay.
Because we're going to say a word, and the first word that comes to your mind, you just blurt it as fast as you can.
There's no backpedaling either, you just gotta...
Okay, I'm ready.
We will start off with pizza.
Cheese.
Husband.
Wife.
Commercials.
Breaks.
Huh?
Like commercial break. Yeah, I was like finishing the word. Yeah. Commercials, TV. Yeah, that works too.
God.
Faith.
Cartoons.
Drawings.
St. Louis.
Best city ever.
Wedding.
Bride.
Axe throwing.
Me.
You.
You got the kill shot.
The champ. No. Yeah, yeah. It's true. It's my new hobby.
Did you retire? Because I saw there was that little video and you're like...
I know. That's the thing. It's like when you end on like a really great shot, like you don't want to mess it up, you know? You just want to go down in history as like...
DJ, you know? Like you retired those first two times.
And then he came back.
Yeah.
Are you into basketball?
I'm into basketball, yeah. I am. Well, because my husband was like... a basketball player.
So is that like now that you're married and
now I'm into it? Yeah, now I'm like slowly getting into it.
Okay. Is there like a team that you like to watch?
I'm always a Lakers fan because I'm in LA, you know what I mean? So like Cali girl, Lakers, yeah. So I have to stay loyal.
So not a Clippers,
you know? Clippers are cool. So Clippers would be second, I guess, like out of loyalty, you know what I mean? It's a real test right now. Like, how much do you know about basketball?
It's Tori Kelly hanging out with JBo and Yoshi on Boost 101.9. She may not know much about basketball, but she'll definitely give you the scoop as to why she wrote the song Change Your Mind.
You look at me like the sun, and I can see that your mind's made up. But daddy, he got a hold on me. I swear that he is the one.
Let's change your mind. Tori Kelly on Boost 101.9 with JBo and Yoshi. Tori, why did you write Change Your Mind? Like, what prompted that?
I wrote that song right after we got engaged, and yeah, the parentals weren't too happy about it, but now things have smoothed out. So I think it was like initial shock, and I think it's also just hard to like let your daughter go, you know, like I'm the oldest and stuff, and so it's just, you know, family stuff is always kind of crazy, but I had to get that song out because it really was a difficult thing for me to go through, and I'm just glad the song was like therapeutic for me, and now there's been a lot of healing since then. So
did that song almost help with that process with your family?
I didn't play it for anyone for a long time, so it was more like for me internally. I was like, you know, going through it, and a lot of my songs are like that. It starts out being kind of selfish, like I need to write this song for my own. The coolest thing about songwriting is because it does for me start out selfish, and then being, you know, at a show, and then suddenly the song grows beyond just me, and I'm seeing other people like relate to it, and I'm hearing stories about it. So that transition is cool for it to go from this thing that just started inside, and then other people are singing along, you know.
Now, has your dad always given you a hard time when it came to whoever you were dating at the moment, or is just the situation just different?
I think the situation's just different. Yeah, they've been kind of strict, I guess, like in a good way. I think they did a pretty decent job in raising me. Yeah, I love my parents. Oh. Yeah. Boost 101.9.
That's Tori Kelly on Boost 101.9. It's JBo and Yoshi hanging out with Tori.
First off, congratulations as well for almost a year of marriage.
Thank you, yeah.
And I know with marriage, they say like the first year can be pretty tough because you're learning about each other and everything.
Yeah.
She laughs.
Yeah.
What's something you and your husband have put into place to kind of help with your marriage thus far?
That's a good question. Prayer is huge for us. So we can tell when we've gone a while. It's like we haven't even like prayed together in a sec, you know, because faith is a big part for both of us, is huge. So I think we go a while and then it's like, oh, you know, we need to, like, because we want to make that a habit, I think, in our marriage. So I'd say that's something we're like really trying to put in place. It helps a lot.
I mean, you can tell even like on your own, like if I'm out of pocket, God, or not prayer time, or even just reading,
reading
your word, like after a while you start to
feel that. Yeah.
I mean, marriage, like husband and wife, that connection isn't there. You're like, okay, hold on a second.
Yeah, it starts with you first. And then, if you're not getting filled, then how can you pour out love to someone else? You know what I mean? So, yeah.
Boost 101.9, JBo and Yoshi talking to Tori Kelly, who could have easily given up on her music career because the world told her she wasn't good enough. Should have been us on Boost 101.9. We're JBo and Yoshi. Tori, you've been through a lot of heartbreak. What would you tell 12-year-old Tori?
Wow, I would tell her she's gonna get rejected a lot from the music industry. I was already kind of in the industry when I was 12. I was signed to a label, so I would tell her, like, hey, this, I know you think this is like your big break or whatever, but you're still a kid. Like, you have a lot of time to figure it out, and just try to be like a normal kid, because your time, it's gonna all make sense like way later. That's what I'd say.
How do you feel like that rejection has molded you into the person you are today?
Oh, it's huge. I mean, I think I'm able now to get on stage every night. Feels like I'm not striving for anything more than what I already have. You know what I mean? I wrote a song called Confetti a long time ago.
But I'm living for right now, 'cause what if tomorrow never comes? I'm not waiting for the confetti to fall.
I was like 18 when I wrote it, and it was, I always hear that song and I'm like, oh, that's still relevant, because it's just basically saying like the lyric is like, people seem to think you'll be happier when you reach the top. So we're always looking at, you know, the next best thing, or grass is greener type of thing. But it's basically, that song is saying like, it's cool to dream, like definitely have goals and like strive to be better and stuff, but even if it doesn't happen, like you can be cool, and also like that just means your route is being redirected. So I had to learn that kind of like the hard way, I guess. But but now it's just crazy listening to that song, because it's like, oh yeah, I'm cool with what I have right now, but at the same time I'm still, you know, striving for my goals. So it's like this tension kind of,
you're striving, but you're like, okay, so I want to be humble.
Yeah. And like, whatever happens is like meant to be.
Tori Kelly on Boost 101.9. If you take her to karaoke, she'll shut the place down. But she loves to karaoke anyways.
Unbreakable Smile by Tori Kelly. It's Boost 101.9, JBo and Yoshi. So Tori, away from the microphone and away from the stage, I hear that you like to do some karaoke.
Where did you hear that from? I don't even know how it happens. Like, it starts out as like, oh, game night. And then it turns into like, let's look up karaoke videos on YouTube. And just like, someone has a speaker in their car, and it literally turns into karaoke. Yeah, because it's all, you know, all like the musician homies and stuff. And so they always have like something. So literally like my friend had a microphone in his car and a whole, you know, whole setup. And then we just did karaoke. Anything Britney Spears is my, that's like my warm up. Yeah, that's the warm up song. And then I think just anything like 90s is kind of a go to. I don't have like a specific song, but I have like an era. You could go R&B 90s, you know, that's your go-to.
Boyz II Men, Blackstreet, all.
Yeah. You and Andre, you and my husband should karaoke together. That's his vibe.
Every once in a while, we like bust out in song in the middle on air.
Yeah.
And then we're like, oh, that was weird. And then we just kind of like move on, but it's always like this like old school like R&B.
Yeah, you vibe. Should. Keep doing that.
Like, whatever.
Keep doing that. Don't change.
You know, everybody has something they geek out over. You'll find out what Tori Kelly geeks out over. Getting a chance to chop it up with Tori Kelly on Boost 101.9 with JBo and Yoshi. Now, Tori, real quick before we let you go, what's something you geek out over?
Food. It's real. She's smiling because she knows. Sorry, put you on the spot now.
I don't know where you want to sit.
Oh, Lord.
Yay. Let's talk about why we fangirl over food.
Hey, yeah. Food's a thing.
I'm interviewing you now.
Oh, okay. I mean, food's like from the Lord. Like, yeah. He made it. I think it tastes good.
Yeah, I think we get excited about like a balanced lifestyle. So we like to eat healthy. And then, but we then it makes us geek out over cheat days,
right?
Because
tastes better.
Yeah, that's
after true. You've kind of like let it chill, like you're not eating like a psycho, your taste buds get to reset,
right?
And then like the kind of naughtier foods taste insane.
And this is
like pizza.
No, but this is us. This is really us. Like we'll be eating, like we'll be at a bomb spot, like she'll Yelp something or whatever, and we'll be eating, and we'll literally be talking about what we're gonna eat next. So to answer your question, yeah, food is definitely. I think
she's not lying.
Kamari Copeland, everyone.
Sabotage.
My guest, my special guest.
What a time.
What a way to end.
Thanks for hanging out. It's JBo and Yoshi on Boost 101.9.
Boost 101.9, St. Louis.